This is a collaboration with Morn 1415, an impressive channel about space animations. The link to his video is in the description below, make sure to subscribe him. This is the best image that we have of an exoplanet. And this is the most accurate image of the atmosphere of an exoplanet. But so far, we have not been able to directly image habitable exoplanets or Earth-like planets. So, when will we see those images? Possibly by 2025. Telescopes such as the European Extremely Large Telescope and the Wide Field Infrared Survey Telescope will be able to produce images similar to this one, a simulation of an Earth-like planet located 4 light-years away. NASA is also working on 2 projects that could provide images with higher resolution. One of the projects is called HAVIX, which stands for Habitable Exoplanet Imaging Mission. HAVIX, a 4-meter space telescope, would be used to image Earth-like planets and to analyze their atmosphere. This telescope would provide images similar to this one, a simulation of an Earth-like planet located 30 light-years away. The other project is called LUVOIR, which stands for Large Ultraviolet Optical Infrared Surveyor. LUVOIR, an 8-meter space telescope, would also be used to image Earth-like planets. This telescope would provide images similar to this one, a simulation of an Earth-like planet located 40 light-years away. In this picture, we can notice the blue color. In fact, this resolution would enable us to distinguish the different continents and oceans of the exoplanet. This other simulation actually shows how the Earth might look like to an extraterrestrial civilization continuously observing the planet for 2 years. Depending on the color of the surface, we might be able to determine the type of vegetation present on the exoplanet. And here there is another simulation of an Earth-like planet imaged by LUVOIR, but this time located 100 light-years away. The decision about which of the 2 telescopes have priority will probably come by the end of this year. It seems to me that LUVOIR has a higher chance of being selected because, on the one hand, it is a general-purpose observatory and, on the other, it seems to provide better resolution. In any case, I believe that more cooperation between different space agencies is important. The selected telescope is expected to be launched by 2035. NASA is also working on how to use the Sun as a gravitational lens. The light coming from space bends around the Sun, eventually converging toward a specific region. Several detectors would be placed 650 astronomical units away from the Earth. With the Space Launch System, the spacecraft could reach destination in about 30 years. The surface of an exoplanet located 100 light-years away could be imaged with a resolution of 10 kilometers across, which would look like something similar to this. Alright, that's all for today. To see all the images of exoplanets taken so far, click the link in the description below and make sure to subscribe to Morn 1415. Thank you very much for watching and please consider subscribing to my channel and activating the notifications. Bye bye.